name is Angela. I come from the United States of America. I travel the world preaching the gospel. I used to hear about Romania in America and the orphans, the gypsies. And I've been here 3 times now. And I realized that this is a really well-off country, more than I thought it was. You guys have big malls. You have a big spa, the largest spa in Europe. So the question is, yes, you have a big mall. Yes, you have a big spa, water slides. But do you have a big God? You do have a big God. What's the name of your big God? Okay. You know, in the... What's that? Mine? I am a Christian. Well, you might be an Orthodox Christian. Orthodox Christian, okay. I am a born-again Christian. I am a Pentecostal. I believe in the power of God. I don't always go to church every week because I travel. I've got a pastor here. He is a pastor in Romania. And he's from America. Ben is from America. His wife is Romanian. And we actually met on Facebook. So a man told me to meet his brother, and we preached together 2 years ago. So Ben and I are brothers and sisters because of our faith in Jesus Christ. Ben used to be an atheist. I used to be a crack smoker. Yeah, I was a crack smoker. Midnight toker. I took LSD. I was an alcoholic. I even looked at movies that were down and dirty. Some of you might like the down and dirty movies. Now I like clean movies like the Hallmark Channel. Hallelujah. My mother watches the Hallmark Channel. But the number one priority in my life is now Jesus Christ. And when I say God, I refer to Jesus Christ. There are many gods in this world. Matter of fact, God said in the Ten Commandments, "Thou shalt not have any other gods before me." So there are other gods. There are idols. I preached in Bali, Indonesia, and they were on their knees bowing to idols. And I marched in there with my Bible, and I called those worshipers to repent. Repent of your idol worship. Now, some of you may go in the Orthodox Onion Dome Church. Onion Dome. Looks like an onion. Right? Yeah. And I've seen people before wiping pictures of Maria and then smooching on her. What does that do? Does anybody out here smooch on pictures of Jesus' mother? Raise your hand. Okay, good. Thank you. I have never smooched a picture of Jesus' mother. I've never smooched a picture of a dead saint. But I have kissed the Bible, and I liked it. Kiss the Bible, sir. I believe that if you will read the Holy Bible, that you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free. It's a promise. You shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. In July 1994, I got on my knees by my father's Bible, and I cried out to God, God help me, God help me, God help me. I was 23 years old. I was raised in church. I knew that God was powerful my whole life. My whole life I believed that Jesus died on the cross for me. But I did not care. I didn't care because I loved my sin. I wanted to sin. Because sin was more fun than being good. That's what I thought. But then I became an alcoholic and a drug addict, and my sin made me a slave. I was a slave. I was a slave to Lucifer. Three archangels, Lucifer, Gabriel, and Michael. But Lucifer wanted to be like God, and God kicked him out of heaven. Jesus said, I saw Satan fall like lightning. For you Harry Potter fans, that's why Harry Potter uses the lightning bolt. Think about that. On your mark, it said, go think. Satan, Harry Potter, witchcraft, lightning bolt. Bye, Satan. Lightning bolt. Harry Potter, witchcraft. Witchcraft is rebellion against God. And if you don't serve Jesus Christ according to the Bible, you will go to hell. Do you believe that? You can't appreciate good news till you hear the bad news. Most people know Jesus loves them. But do you know what happens for those of you that don't obey Jesus? Do you know? Preaching the Holy Bible, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. No one goes to God except through the Son of God. Jesus died on the cross for your sins. He was buried. God raised him from the dead 3 days later. He was seen by over 500 people according to the scriptures. What must I do to be saved? Repent. Believe the gospel. about my job now. Lock and load. I'm going to start firing this thing. Bam. Are you kids listening? Are you listening? There will be a final exam in heaven. You're either guilty or not guilty. You got two choices in this life, boys and girls. Make Jesus your attorney in the courtroom of God, or say, I'm going to represent myself in the courtroom. According to the Bible, there is only one advocate with God. It's not Mary. It's not your dad's saints. Some of you kids, or maybe we'll say your grandparents, some of your grandparents like to celebrate the dead saints just so they can get drunk and get wild and crazy. How do you know that, Sister Angela? Because a guy in Serbia told me. I heard that in Serbia, boys and girls. I heard in Serbia that people get drunk on saints' holidays. What does that have to do with Jesus dying on the cross? Will somebody please explain your religion to me? How can you call yourself a Christian if you're getting drunk? You tell me a drunk Christian, and I'll tell you somebody headed for hell. That's what I'm going to tell you. There's no such thing as a drunk Christian. The Bible says no drunkard will enter the kingdom of God. Apostle Paul talked to the Corinthian church about this problem. The Bible says there is a way that seems right unto man, but in the end it leads to death. Maybe I should go say it over there by the Onion Dome. There is a way that seems right. Thank you. I'm trying to preach softly, but I think I need to bring the hammer harder. Say, preach it harder. Preach it harder. Sir, are you ready to meet God? Are you ready to face God? If you died today, would you go to heaven or hell? You need to know these answers. This is the most important question of your life. The most important day of your life is the day you die. Because you face God and you give an account at the judgment seat. You have an appointment waiting on you. It's called Judgment Day. If there were no Judgment Day, I would not bother preaching and scratching my voice. But because there is a hell, there is a heaven, and Jesus shed his blood on the cross, I want to lift up the Lamb of God. Because the Word of God says, when Jesus is lifted up, woo! He will draw all men unto himself. It's speaking of the cross of Christ. Jesus did not die on the cross so you could go smooch a picture of Mary. Think about that. There is only one highly exalted, and that is Jesus Christ. God will not share His glory with anyone, including the Orthodox Church. You need to get saved. You need to get born again. You need to get in right standing with God. I repented of my sins. That's why I am a real Christian. Jesus said, go and sin no more. Jesus did not say, just go to the church and tell the priest you're sorry. That actually goes against the Word of God to call a man your father and tell your sins to him and ask him to forgive you. There is only one that can forgive sins. That's Jesus Christ. Only Jesus can forgive sins. Only Jesus can wash away sins. Can anybody hear me? Can anybody hear me? Thank you, ma'am. I think Ben will share now in Romanian language. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.